And now we will learn how to change the value of the variables. That means changing what's inside the data field box where the columns and rows intersect. If we go over to Stata and we open the same data sheet we've been working on, we see that these are the values. The values in brown are non-numeric, and the values in black are numeric. And we are going to learn in this video different ways to change them. In this video, I'm going to show you four different ways to change the values of the variables. First, we'll show you how to just change them, which means just overtype the characters in the data field. For example, if I wanted to change anyone who visited the pool 10 times and change that value to the number 5,000, I could just click right in that data field and overtype the value with the number 5,000 and hit enter. I can keep hitting enter so the cursor goes down to the next instance of the number 10 and overtype it with the number 5,000. Then I can come down here to the, I skipped one of the number 10s, change it to 5,000, just overtype it. That's all I have to do. Then I can save the data sheet to make sure that I don't lose my changes. But again, all I did was look at the data sheet and find the instance or occurrence of the number 10 and overtype it with the number 5,000. Now let's see what happens when we run a table. If we tab visits and hit enter, you can see that there are three appearances or three instances of the number 5,000. You may also notice that in the results window, if you scroll up a little, you can see that Stata put the code that you could have typed in if you wanted to change it with code rather than typing it in. But this particular code is called the replace command, and it will only replace one data field at a time. So you can see doing the overtype or using the replace command is very inefficient or even impossible if we had a data sheet of 5,000 observations and 20 or 30 variables. It would be impossible for the human eye to go through everything one by one and change each instance of the number 10 to the number 5,000 manually. And typing in this code is the same thing as doing it manually. So that means that the second way that we will learn to change the values in the data fields will be using the replace command from the command line. Let's use the replace command to change the values back to the number 10. If we take a look at what was typed in here, we can see the first one we changed was, well, let's take a look at what the actual syntax and the actual code says. The first one says replace, which is the command, visits, which is the variable that we're changing, equal 5,000, which is the value that we're changing it to. And when it says into, it means in the second row of this particular column. So the field or the little box in the second row of the column or the variable visits will be changed to 5,000. Now I'm going to copy this into the command line and I'm going to change it to the number 10. So what this reads is replace visits equal 10 in 2. That means replace the second observation in the column of visits, change that particular box to the number 10. If we take a quick look at the data, we can see that we were successful in changing the second observation in the column visits to 5,000. But after I hit enter, this number in this box will change back to the number 10. So now I'm going to hit enter. And it says one real change made. Look back at the data and you see it changed the second observation in the variable visits to the number 10. Let's change them all back. Let's scroll up a little. See, the second one we did was in row 8. So we replaced in the column visits in the 8th observation, we overwrote what was there with the number 5,000. Now I'm going to copy that to the command line and say, no, let's change it back to the number 10. So after I hit enter, you will see in the data sheet, the 8th row in the column visits will be changed back to the number 10. I hit enter. Stata confirms it's changed back. We look at the data and we can see here's the 8th row. It has changed back to the number 10. Now we only have to change the 5th one back to the number 10, and of course that's easy. Let's go back to the code that Stata put for us when we originally overtyped it manually. I'm going to copy it into the command line and change the 5th row in the column visit. That particular box should change to the number 10. I hit enter. Then when I open the data sheet, I see in the 5th row that has been changed back to the number 10. Now obviously these two ways are very inefficient for reasons that I mentioned. If we had thousands of observations and dozens of variables, we could not go through each box one at a time. We need to be able to tell Stata, take every instance of this particular value and change it to what we need. So in order to do that, we will use the recode command. For example, in the variable visits, we wish to change any observed value from 10 to 5,000. So even if we had hundreds of rows and there were dozens of appearances of the number 10 as the value, we could change all of them to the number 5,000 in one shot. Now you may well ask, why? Why would we bother changing the number 10 to the number 5,000? The answer is, who knows? Often you must change the numeric value of a variable from one number to another when you're running analyses for social science. And there could be any reason, but at least let's see how the command works. Before we recode, we take a look at the data and we see in the column of visits there are 1, 2, 3 observations that equal the number 10 in row number 2, row number 5, and row number 8 respectively. If we use the recode command properly, that means when we come back here, after only one line of code, all three of these observations should be changed to the number 5,000. The syntax for recode is very simple. Type the word recode, then type the name of the variable, in this case visits, then open up a parenthesis, type the number that you're changing from, then equal, then the number you're changing it to, and close parentheses. So this will tell Stata, recode or change the value of any variable or any cell in the column of visits from 10 to the number 5,000. After we hit enter, it says we have 3 changes made. And when we look at the data sheet, we see field row number 2, row number 5, and row number 8 have been changed in one shot to 5,000. Let's go ahead and change it back. Let's copy from the results window the code that we typed, paste it into the command line, and change it back by saying to Stata, let's change any instance of the number, any instance of the number 5,000, which there are now 3 of them, please change back to the number 10. And then when we hit enter, we come back and we can see even if there were 100, even if there were 1,000 out of 20,000 rows and 1,000 of them were the number 10, in one shot, all 1,000 would have been changed to the number 5,000. So that's how you use recode, and it is very efficient. Now the other more efficient way to change the values of the variables would be to use the same replace command that we used up here in step 2, except add a simple logical test. That means it would change all the values at once, even if there were hundreds of them. and it's very simple. The code looks like this. You type the word replace, then you type the variable that you're replacing, and then you type in that variable, in this case, replace visits equal 5,000, because that's what you're replacing it with, then hit the space bar, then type in your test, if visits equal equal 10. Now, why did we type in two equal signs on this side, but only one equal sign on this side? I promise I will explain in a moment. But what this code is showing is we're asking Stata to replace every value of 10 for this variable visit with 5,000. So it's like saying replace visits with the number 5,000 if it is the number 10. So when we hit the enter key and we look back at the data, we see that there were three replacements made for 5,000. And now we can type in basically the same code and change it back. Let me copy. Don't copy the little dot here on the end. Just copy the same code. Now we're going to fix it by saying replace every instance of the number 10 with the number 5,000. Replace the number 5. Replace all of the variable visit with the number 10 if and only if that value is already 5,000. Hit enter, go back, and you can see now it changed back all three instances of the number 5,000 to the number 10. So you may well ask, why did we have only one equal sign over here and two equal signs over there? And that brings us to a general rule in Stata. Please note, when commanding Stata to do something, like assigning a value to a variable, we only use one equal sign. However, when doing a logical test to see or to check if something equals something else, that's when we use two equal signs. And this is a reoccurring theme that will be explained more deeply in future videos.